This is a University of Sheffield Health Service screencast. Hello and welcome to this screencast on the contraceptive implant. In this screencast we'll cover what it is, how it works, how effective it is, its advantages, and lastly any disadvantages. The contraceptive implant is a member of a group called the Long-Acting and Reversible Contraceptives, or LARCs for short. We'll first talk a bit about LARCs, and then specifically about the implant. There are four different types of long-acting reversible contraceptives. The first is a copper intrauterine device, called IUD, or copper coil. Then there is the intrauterine system, or IUS. Thirdly, there are contraceptive injections. And lastly, there is the contraceptive implant. LARCs are suited for women who want contraception without having to remember to take it daily, or at the time of intercourse. Their effects are also reversible, so there's no long-term effect on your fertility. It has been found that women who use LARCs have less unwanted pregnancies than those who use the pill, because the pill is only 99% effective if it's used perfectly. LARCs are particularly suited to those women who have a body mass index, or BMI, over 30, have diabetes or migraines with or without aura, and those who can't take estrogen-containing contraceptives. It should be remembered that LARCs do not provide protection against sexually transmitted infections, so use a condom in addition if you think you are at risk. The contraceptive implant is a flexible piece of plastic that slowly releases progesterone. It is placed under the skin of the inner aspect of the upper arm. It works by preventing ovulation, which is the release of the eggs from the ovaries. It's been shown to be over 99% effective. The advantages of the contraceptive implant are as follows. Once fitted, it can be used for up to 3 years and no routine follow-up is required in the interim unless problems occur. It can be used safely for women with a BMI of over 30 and for those breastfeeding. Fertility returns immediately following removal of the implant. Implants are not associated with any increase in risk of venous thromboembolism or loss in bone mineral density. Studies show that there is no association with side effects such as weight change, mood change, loss of libido, or headaches. If the implant fails, the overall risk of ectopic pregnancy is reduced when using contraceptive implants. This is when compared to using no contraception at all. The specific disadvantages of the contraceptive implant is as follows. It has to be inserted and removed by a minor surgical procedure. It can be affected by certain medications that can cause liver enzyme induction. If you are unsure, ask your doctor. Acne may improve, occur, or worsen during the use of implants. 1 in 5 users will have no bleeding, whilst almost half will have infrequent, frequent, or prolonged bleeding. These bleeding patterns are likely to remain whilst the implant is used. For further information and to view the reference material we've used, please note the following. You can view these only if you've enabled the annotations function. This is the end of the screencast on the contraceptive implant.